the forgotten passport to the airport. Here she is handing it off to Dusty, and with his help and a few other Delta employees along the way, Lauren's passport made it to San Juan just in time.
I consider that the greatest wedding gift we could have asked for.
This was so much larger than me. During this whole process, it really taught me so much about the importance of teamwork.
And we made it on the cruise with about an hour and a half to spare.
Lauren and Joe had a fabulous time on their honeymoon cruise and can't wait to see a couple of special guests they've invited to their reception in a few weeks. Dusty and another Delta employee who was instrumental in making it all happen.
I felt like probably the luckiest bride on earth.
Having Dusty do all that for us really kind of instilled faith in me that there are still good people out there.
We have so many friends and family that have been following our story and are so excited to meet Dusty. So to just bring him and his fellow flight attendants into our community, I'm so excited. I hope we stay friends for much longer after this.
Oh my goodness. And in addition to the couple's gratitude, Delta Airlines spotlighted Dusty's actions and problem-solving skills with the newlyweds on the company's website.
Wow. If there's a will, there's a way.
Oh, they're so fortunate that they got that passport in time.
Have you ever forgotten something important on a trip?
No, because I am very strict on myself and my husband, and that's always the first question I ask. Do you have your passport?
Okay, so you're that person.
I'm that person.
Okay, well, good. Very good. I'm so glad it worked out for him.
Yes.
Let's hold on. I got to get ready here. Let's take a quick look outside here. Eventually, we are looking at a beautiful conditions right now. We do have a first alert weather day, though. Let me get you ready for that coming up.
Plus, Kennewick fire crews took on a wildfire Friday near the Columbia Center Boulevard exit on State Route 240. How long it took them to put it out. The Yakima County Sheriff's Office is getting a big upgrade to its patrol cars. How this technology will help them in the day-to-day work when it comes to patrolling the streets and answering calls for help. Good Morning Northwest continues right now.
This is Apple Valley News Now. Good morning, Northwest, on your side.
Good morning, and thank you for joining us. I'm Jill Sperling.
I'm Jason Valentine. Welcome to Monday. It's 6:01 on this Monday morning. Good morning, Jill.
Good morning. Very happy to hear slightly cooler temperatures, but
yes,
we have the wind to talk about.
We have wind to talk about, and again, I've been coining the term brief relief from the heat.
Yes.
For the next
well,
2 days,
that's true.
We'll have some relief, but triple digits returning later on this week. Let's take a quick look outside. It is beautiful at Giese Stadium, home of the Dust Devils, and it is beautiful throughout our areas, but do get ready for winds to start to pick up and become quite the factor today. We have a red flag warning, hence our first alert weather day today, and we are going to be tracking heavier winds, even a wind advisory for Kittitas County. They could see gusts up to 50 miles per hour, sustained winds 25 to 35. The rest of our cities about 10 to 20 mile per hour winds. So do get ready for a blustery Monday ahead, heightening fire danger with low humidity and dry conditions. Plenty of sunshine today, but about 10 or so degrees off what we saw yesterday, 84 for Yakima. We're 89 in the Tri-Cities and over in the lovely Blue Mountain region in Walla Walla, 87. So folks, a lot to get you updated on. A weather alert day today due to that red flag warning. Much cooler today, but again, as I was saying earlier, brief relief from the heat. I'll have all that coming up, but for right now, I'm going to send it back to Jill.
A wildfire Friday afternoon in Kennewick shut down eastbound lanes of 240, bringing it down to one lane. The fire was reported just after 2 p.m. Witnesses reported seeing the flames between the Columbia Center Boulevard and Steptoe exits. It's not known what started the fire at this time, but crews remained at the scene over the next few hours to make sure hotspots didn't flare back up. Much of the flames were out by half an hour and the lanes opened a short time later. And Pasco fire crews were also at work in the heat after a wildfire was reported on Road 52. Witnesses reported it was near Burns Road and may have been started by fireworks. Crews got to the scene just after 2 o'clock and the flames were out within 20 minutes. With our hot, dry and windy weather, fire officials are asking people to be mindful of using anything that can start a fire easily. And we're learning more about a wildfire that broke out in Walla Walla County. Fire crews were called to the area of 15th Avenue and Reese Avenue just after 11:30 Thursday morning in Walla Walla County. Walla Walla City fire crews, as well as Walla Walla Fire Districts 4 and 8, were called to the scene. The fire was spotted along the end of West Reese Avenue, and it was under control by noon. No injuries were reported, but the cause of the fire is still under investigation. Three people are dead after a fatal crash near Othello Saturday night. According to Washington State Patrol, a 30-year-old driver was traveling eastbound on State Route 26, approaching the intersection of Road D Southeast. His vehicle crashed head-on into a vehicle traveling westbound on State Route 26, killing all three occupants. The driver of the first vehicle has been transported to a local hospital. His condition is unknown at this time. Yakima County Sheriff's deputies have been upgrading their technology to keep up with standards of modern-day policing. Apple Valley News Now's Emily Goodell tells us they're just now putting the finishing touches on their latest upgrade.
New patrol vehicles mean more space and less stress for Yakima County Sheriff's deputies when they hit the road.
Knowing that we can get to our calls without a car breaking down, having nice air conditioning and having comfort while we're driving in our offices.
The cars gutted, then built up from scratch and outfitted with the latest technology.
Our lights and siren package, including the rumbler, which makes a really low, loud noise that people can actually hear.
Plus, new in-car cameras to match their Axon body cams.
The dash cams are going to be great in the sense that we will be able to video wherever this vehicle drives.
There's also a camera inside the back of the patrol car that'll record suspects placed under arrest. It'll also allow deputies to view that footage in real time. The dash cam also comes with an automated license plate reader.
This lens is doing the actual LPR stuff, and this lens is doing the recording.
The system's set up to alert deputies when a passing car has a license plate that's flagged as part of an investigation.
So it reads license plates anywhere that we're around, and so it'll allow us eventually to find out if it's a wanted vehicle, if it's a stolen vehicle, if it's a vehicle we need to be paying attention to because maybe there's a missing person related to it.
Deputies say the new dash cams not only increase transparency, but add a layer of evidence that can be used to back up their investigations when a case makes it to the courtroom. In Yakima, Emily Goodell, Apple Valley News Now.
They're still wrapping up the installation and testing on those new dash cams, but say people should start seeing them in use this week. A Union Gap man has been identified in a fatal car crash near Toppenish Saturday. According to a report from the Washington State Patrol, 34-year-old Felipe Uriogstegui was driving northbound on SR 97 just before 4 a.m., about 2 miles north of Toppenish, when he rear-ended the vehicle in front of him. Authorities say the man then drove off the road and the vehicle rolled before coming to a rest on its wheels. He died at the scene. According to the Washington State Patrol, his family has been notified of his death. The other driver in the vehicle that was rear-ended was not hurt. The UA Plumbers and Steamfitters Local 598 has signed a labor agreement with PermaFix Environmental Services for the Hanford cleanup effort. The goal of this partnership is to prevent the release of radioactive and hazardous materials into the environment at the Hanford site. By grouting the waste in tanks, the Hanford site is hoping to take a crucial step towards reducing environmental risks and protecting the environment. The agreement will also work for allowing safe transport and disposal off-site.
I don't think going from 0 gallons to a couple million gallons a year would be something we could possibly handle ourselves without an agreement like this. So. Really looking at that strategy over the next 5 to 10 years, it's important for everybody to be able to have a operation like this, and it means the DOE can close the tanks quicker and efficiently and safely.
The U.S. Department of Energy says it is constantly exploring options on how to keep the 56 million gallons of radioactive and hazardous chemical waste stored properly. Saturday night at approximately 10 p.m., officers were dispatched to the 900 block of North Cleveland Street for a weapons complaint. And after speaking with involved parties and witnesses, it was determined that a shooting happened in the area. A canine track was conducted with the assistance of the Benton County Sheriff's Office. However, no suspect was located. At this time, the suspect in this case is still outstanding and the investigation is ongoing. If anyone has information about the incident, they're asked to call the non-emergency number at 509-628-0333. Jason Valentine returns now with a look at your morning weather forecast.
Folks, it's a weather alert day with a red flag warning, meaning, well, we have heightened fire danger today due to high winds. Also, more sunshine, cooler temperatures. I'll get you ready for your Monday coming right up.
Plus, a recent decision from President Biden raises questions about how much the government knew about the assassination of President John F. Kennedy.
Income can affect mental health. People living below the poverty level are twice as likely to report serious psychological issues. More at applevalleynewsnow.com.
Sponsored locally by Prosser Memorial Health. Learn more at prosserhealth.org. This is how we care.
For over 600 different premium cigars, including every cigar rated 95 and higher in the last decade, it's the Educated Cigar. For 115 different fine pipe tobaccos and 55 different briarwood pipes from England, Germany, and Italy, it's the Educated Cigar. For 95 and higher rated wines and White Bluff IPAs, it's the Educated Cigar in Richland.
When you need legal help, trust Quantum Legal. We're here for you in times of trouble, whether you need assistance with criminal defense, personal injury, or have been injured on the job. Law is a complicated matter. Our team of experts will fight for you and help you find the best solution for your situation. Don't let life's challenges get the best of you. We're here to help. Call us today at 509-783-5551 or visit our website at quantumlegal.com.
Stan, where's Alice? She's supposed to stay with us.
Oh, shoot. Where could she?
Hey, everybody. I'm Alice. I'm new here. The new zipline ride looks so fun. You go back and forth. Awesome.
And we've lost control of the Alice situation.
Triple Play has fun for everyone, including the brand new zipline ride. And it's all attached to a cozy hotel.
I mean, she's a natural spokasaur who isn't tempted to eat anyone. You know, because she's an herbivore.
Tonight,
she was set up.
It's Guess Big or Go Home.
Somebody had to go.
You're shady as hell.
Can you guess who's related to who on an all-new Claim to Fame tonight on ABC?
With K2 Vision RLE, you can throw away your distance and reading glasses. Plus, you'll never develop a cataract. Schedule a free Zoom consultation with us today. K2 Vision RLE. No glasses, no contacts, no readers.
Next ET.
Oh, hail the queen. Let's go.
Our Queen Latifah exclusive. What she's revealing about Girls Trip 2.
I'm just ready to laugh all day.
Next ET.
Tonight at 7 on Apple Valley News Now.
An awesome Idaho float adventure. Fly the Northwest.
Apple Valley News Now at 6 Tuesday.
Welcome back on this Monday morning. Well, the search continues for answers to lingering questions stemming from the JFK assassination. A judge upheld an order by President Biden keeping thousands of documents from the investigation under wraps. But after six decades, a new name has emerged. Here's ABC's Derek Dennis.
This morning, a recent decision by President Biden concerning documents related to the JFK assassination is raising new questions about what the government knew and when. The president, late last month, issued a final order certifying documents from the JFK investigation to be released. But the New York Times reports 4,684 of the files remain either partially or fully withheld from the public's eye.
On June 30th, President Biden washed his hands of the JFK matter and said that this would be his last order about JFK.
Jefferson Morley is editor of the blog JFK Facts. He says some of the files being withheld could shed light on the CIA's investigation before JFK's death.
What remains is about 4,400 documents from a variety of federal agencies, primarily the CIA, that still contain some redactions ranging from a word to a paragraph to a page to the whole document.
Morley says there's one name that's been a mystery all these years and was made public in the files, Reuben Efron, who worked for the CIA and was intercepting Lee Harvey Oswald's mail in the months before the assassination.
Reuben Efron died 30 years ago. So they're not protecting the name of a living person. They're protecting the operational activity that he was engaged in, which was reading Lee Harvey Oswald's mail. what it shows is that the CIA was running some kind of intelligence operation, we don't know exactly what, around Lee Harvey Oswald, the accused assassin, while President Kennedy was still alive.
So it will now be up to individual government agencies to determine if and when more documents from the investigation are released in the future. Coming up, record temps and flooding spread throughout the United States. We'll have that and I'll return with your First Alert weather forecast. It is a First Alert weather day. Let me get you ready for it coming up next.
Come see us today and feel the power of Pingree. Bronco.
From Apple Valley News Now, this is Medically Speaking.
My name is Lauren Martin. I started to work out at Hanford in 1982. And for 20 years, I worked with the fleet, repairing cranes, locomotives, cars, ambulances, fire trucks, everything. After 20 years, then I came down with a disease. And my doctors in Spokane strongly encouraged me to change careers. It's just amazing. Just recently, I had a need for a walker. Right there it was. If I need any supplies, they're there for me. All I have to do is pick up the phone and it's there.
So we'll definitely evaluate their past employment. As a registered nurse myself, I'll look through their medical records and I'll look to see maybe what medical conditions they have, and we'll be very upfront with them, honest about whether they do have a claim that could warrant benefits or not.
An awesome Idaho float adventure featuring good times, sun, and fun.
Great place out here. Just enjoy the river and soak up some sun.
Fly the Northwest.
In my opinion, one of the most beautiful parts of Idaho.
Apple Valley News Now at 6 Tuesday.
Next live, Issa Rae from Barbie.
Let's do it.
From Claim to Fame,
Kevin and Frankie Jonas
are back.
Today at 9 on Apple Valley News Now.
Portions of Apple Valley News Now, sponsored by Lord's Health and Trios Health, making communities healthier.
From Apple Valley News Now, First Alert Weather with Jason Valentine.
Good Monday morning, everyone. Hope you had a wonderful weekend and hope you stayed cool as well. We do have cooler temperatures today, but it is a First Alert weather day as we are looking at a red flag warning. So let's get right into that. That's until 11 o'clock tonight. And again, red flag warnings are warnings for first responders that we have elevated fire danger. So low humidity, gusty winds, we definitely have that, and dry conditions. So that's until 11 o'clock tonight. Those winds will slow down overnight. Also very heavy winds in the Kittitas County area. We're going to be seeing between 25 to 35 mile per hour winds there sustained from 8 o'clock this morning to 8 o'clock tonight. Could even see gusts up to 50 miles per hour. The rest of our areas around 10 to 20 mile per hour sustained winds at times. So do get ready for some heavy winds today. And again, that elevates our fire danger throughout our areas and kind of settling down into the mid-teens for most of our areas. We were in the 20 mile per hour range just an hour ago in Toppenish. So folks, we do expect those winds to get heavier in Ellensburg and about where they're going to be, maybe a little bit heavier as we move along in our day. So winds are going to slow down overnight and be pretty much much slower, 5 to 10 mile per hour as we get into tomorrow, as we get into Wednesday, and picking up just slightly into our weekend. We could We're going to keep an eye on it. If it raises just a little bit on our Saturday, that's our best chance of red flag warnings reappearing as we look at those warm temperatures, well, returning as well. So temperatures this morning, we are very warm. We are in mid to upper 60s for most of our areas, if not lower 70s. So very warm conditions, 61. Our cool spot in Ellensburg. We are going to get a break from the heat today and tomorrow, but then we're going to see those temperatures rise back up again starting Thursday, back at least for the Tri-Cities and some other cities, back to the triple digits for your Thursday and Friday. And then as we get to our weekend, slightly less hot, but folks, the heat will be back on. So if you've been looking for relief, the next 2 days are it. So on our future cast, we expect to see plain old clear skies as we move along in the next couple of days. Maybe a hint of clouds here and there, but really that's inconsequential as we're just looking at beautiful conditions continuing. So our highs today, mid 80s for Yakima, Toppenish, 76, a chilly 76 for Ellensburg. Over in the mid-Columbia, mid to upper 80s, and in the lovely Blue Mountain region, mid 80s as well. 7-day forecast. Again, today's an alert day. Thursday and Friday are alert days as well, with those triple digits returning to the Yakima Valley. Look at all that sunshine. It's a winning slot machine with all that sunshine. 88 tomorrow, 95 by Wednesday, then triple digits by Thursday. For the Tri-Cities area, alert days today for that red flag warning and those winds, and alert days Thursday and Friday with 102 degrees. We're going to keep a close eye on those temperatures. And again, best chance of a return of the red flag warning will be on Saturday. But for the interim, we have more sunshine on the way. And again, enjoy these cooler temperatures. The heat will definitely be back on. So again, folks, red flag warning today till 11 o'clock tonight. So heightened fire danger for all of our areas. And that wind advisory in the Kittitas County from 8 o'clock this morning to 8 o'clock tonight. Be careful out there and enjoy the cooler temps.
Killer storms and deadly heat are looming over tens of millions of Americans as dangerously high temperatures claimed more lives. Raging floodwaters brought a family outing to a tragic end. Here's ABC's Andrew Dimbert.
The death toll is expected to rise after a flash flood outside of Philadelphia. Five people were killed, and overnight, two children were still missing, including a 9-month-old boy and 2-year-old girl.
Miraculously, Dad and his son were able to get safely. However, the grandmother, the mother, and the two children were swept away by the floodwaters. We have recovered the mother, and she is one of the deceased.
Authorities in Bucks County say the family was visiting from South Carolina when their vehicle got swept away by the floodwaters.
That could have been any one of us leaving our house and just going to the grocery store or something.
The heat turning deadly in San Diego County. Police say a biker died after trying to help hikers who had no food or water. 14 states are under heat watches and warnings today. El Paso, Texas has seen triple-digit temperatures for 30 consecutive days. Four people at a car show had to be taken to the hospital for heat exposure. A biologist in neighboring New Mexico is warning about the impact on wildlife, telling NPR that birds are struggling to adapt.
The birds that are most susceptible to heat stress are just going to be gone.
In the Northeast, country star Jason Aldean had to cut short a concert in Connecticut because of the heat.
It was pretty intense last night at the show. Anybody that was at the show knows how hot it was.
And now, smoke from the historic wildfires burning in Canada is triggering more air quality alerts. Dense smoke is expected over the eastern Great Lakes and parts of New York and Pennsylvania, while hazy skies are expected for much of the Northeast today. Andrew Dimbert, ABC News, New York.
Major airports across the Northeast are warning of significant delays to flights as storms move across the region. All flights servicing the major airports around New York City and Boston faced ground stops early Sunday afternoon. Travelers are advised to contact their airline for their flight status before heading to the airport. Pilots with United Airlines have reached a tentative agreement with the airline on a new 4-year contract. The new deal will give pilots a substantial pay raise, up to 40%. The Airline Pilots Association says the agreement also includes better retirement benefits, job security, and addresses quality of life issues. The union says the agreement ends a stalemate that has lasted 4 years. Its 16,000 members still must approve the deal. When we return on Good Morning Northwest, Bank of America is set to ship out $100 million to customers who were allegedly harmed by the bank. We'll tell you how to know if you qualify next.
Welcome to the Village Bistro. I wanted to share with you some of the things we have on our menu. We're open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. One of our favorite dishes here is the keto bowl. It's loaded with delicious vegetables such as squash, zucchini, broccoli, and then you get to pick your protein such as smoked Polish sausage, chicken, shrimp, or steak. Another favorite dish we have here is our meatball sub. You have to try this. It is delicious. We love to get to know each customer and we want you to feel like family when you're here. We can't wait to see you at the Village Bistro.
With K2 Vision RLE, you can throw away your distance and reading glasses. Plus, you'll never develop a cataract. Schedule a free Zoom consultation with us today. K2 Vision RLE. No glasses, no contacts, no readers.
This summer, happiness is a new Chevy. You can go farther, tow more, and bring along everyone you love. Your road to happiness begins in a new Chevy. Get 1.9% financing on all 2023 Silverado 1500 Crew Cab LT TurboMax pickups, or get $4,250 total cash allowance when you trade in an eligible vehicle. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
This is Medically Speaking.
At West Richland Family Dental and Prime Dental Pasco, we want to remind you, your oral health is important. We know that life can get busy. Don't let your family's oral health take a back seat. At West Richland Family Dental and Prime Dental Pasco, we offer extended hours. That's right, we are open from 7 a.m. until 7 p.m., Monday through Friday, plus Saturdays for when the week gets to be too full. We want you to smile healthy and live happy. No insurance? No problem. At West Richland Family Dental and Prime Dental Pasco, our membership plan starts at just $79 and costs only $35 a month. That's two cleanings, x-rays, and much more for just $35 a month. Learn more at WRFDC.com or PDPNW.com. Find us at one of our two locations, West Richland Family Dental and Prime Dental Pasco. Stunning smiles for the whole family.
I'm Buzz the Bee from the Painting Bees. We do interior painting and cabinetry as well. We have a full crew that takes care of everything, and all we really want you to do is to kick back and relax. Visit our website or call us at 591-8160.
Smoke City for Less. We are open 7 days a week with now five locations.
Welcome back on this Monday morning. Well, double dipping on fees, withholding credit card rewards, and opening fake accounts. And now Bank of America is paying the price. The bank was fined $250 million by U.S. federal regulators for allegedly harming customers. Of those fines, $100 million is set to go directly to consumers who were impacted by the bank's alleged wrongdoing. The Consumer Financial Protection Bureau says some customers have already been compensated, but others might be waiting a while before they get the money they're owed. The CFPB says if an account was fraudulently opened in your name, it would appear on your bank statements or credit report. Both reports should list the bank accounts and credit cards you've opened. If you see one you don't recognize from Bank of America and have no record of opening it, there's a chance it could be fraudulent. Well, some of these records can be accessed online. Consumer advocacy experts recommend calling Bank of America's customer service line directly and asking if you were a victim. Well, Americans are feeling optimistic about the future. The University of Michigan tracked a 13% rise in consumer sentiment in July. That's the second straight month of improvement. It's also the most optimistic Americans have felt since September of 2021. Experts say the rise was largely attributed to inflation slowing down and stability in labor markets. Still, expectations for inflation rates remained at their lowest level since early 2021. Coming up, police in New York have a suspect in custody after a years-long search for an alleged serial killer. That's coming up next on Good Morning Northwest.
This is the 2023 Nissan Rogue. With a surprisingly fuel-efficient V6 turbo engine, you can go from zero to fun in no time and leave basic far behind. The 2023 Nissan Rogue. Anything but basic.
Now get 0% financing for 36 months on select trims. Or get a low $419 per month lease on Rogue.
Everybody in the Tri-Cities has been to a Hubby's pizza party, right? You haven't? Acquire the Hubby's habit and book your party today. Delicious, mouth-watering food made with only the freshest ingredients. It's party time at Hubby's Pizza, a hometown favorite for nearly 45 years. Book your party today.
For over 600 different premium cigars, including every cigar rated 95 and higher in the last decade, it's the Educated Cigar. For 115 different fine pipe tobaccos and 55 different briarwood pipes from England, Germany, and Italy, it's the Educated Cigar. For 95 and higher rated wines and White Bluff IPAs, it's the Educated Cigar in Richland.
From Apple Valley News Now, this is Medically Speaking.
The Pacific Clinic is a health, sports, and medical campus where we feel like we're a one-stop shop. Primary care is everything that you do here at the Pacific Clinic. We really focus on preemptive care. And what that means to us is going out and playing tennis and working on that proprioception, that balance, that social aspect, flexibility, all those things.
Living an active lifestyle is extremely important to our health. Research shows that just by incorporating exercise into our daily lives, we can reduce our risk of cardiovascular disease by 50%. So cutting your risk in half is amazing. And just by incorporating regular exercise, we add years to our life.
Stress is the primary reason why living an active lifestyle is so important, because it reduces stress. Stress brings on anxiety, depression, all of the things that we don't want to feel.
So there's some really good benefits to cold therapy, specifically with regards to neurotransmitters. What's important about those neurotransmitters is when they go up, it improves your mood. And so it's become a really good treatment option for depression. And as far as the hot therapy, things like a sauna are really good at preventing cardiovascular disease, Alzheimer's disease, and even some respiratory diseases. I would recommend that folks take advantage of all the services we have to offer here at the clinic. You can make significant strides toward improving your health by utilizing all that we have to offer.
This is Broadway's Rock of Ages Band, July 21st at Legends Casino Hotel.
The suspect in a New York serial killer investigation has made their first appearance in court. And four people are dead after a man goes on a shooting spree through a Georgia neighborhood.
And it's a weather alert day with a red flag warning, a wind advisory, and cooler temperatures throughout. I'll get you prepared my first alert weather forecast.
This is Apple Valley News Now. Good morning, Northwest, on your side.
Good morning, and thank you for joining us. I'm Jill Sperling.
And I'm Jason Valentine. Welcome to the work week. And again, we need our Monday mornings to define our Friday afternoons. Yes. We have to kind of suffer through a few things. So hopefully it's not too bad. Hope you have a wonderful weekend. Jill, how are you this morning?
I'm doing great. Haven't had my coffee this morning. So suffering through my Monday morning, but
okay.
I'll get through it. I'll be fine.
We are two of the few people who haven't had their coffee this morning.
It's true. And yes, we get up super early.
We certainly do. Let's take a look outside. And we have quite a lot to talk about today, Jill. Beautiful sunshine, but we also have winds to talk about already this morning. And that is due to our first alert weather alert day. We have fire weather. We have it until 11 o'clock tonight with a red flag warning, and that is going to be all day today. So do get ready for quite a bit of wind action. Again, red flag warning till 11 o'clock tonight. Low humidity, gusty winds, and dry conditions are what signify a red flag warning, and that is definitely what we have today. We even have a wind advisor for Kittitas County. So get ready for blustery conditions. Sunny skies today, but cooler temperatures. We're around 10 or so degrees off of what we saw for our weekend. So 84 for Yakima, 89 for the Tri-Cities, and in Walla Walla, we're around 87. So chilly, chilly conditions. So folks, get ready. Weather alert day, that red flag warning. Much cooler today, but triple digits will be returning. So it is a brief relief the next 2 days. I'll have your forecast coming up, but for right now, let's send it back to Jill.
Now to New York and the Gilgo Beach serial killings. A suspect described as a demon and an ogre is in custody, ending, for now, a years-long search. Now prosecutors are trying to build their case and possibly link him to more of the killings. Here's ABC's Rhiannon Alley.
This morning, a new search for evidence in the case against suspected Gilgo Beach serial killer Rex Huerman. Investigators on Long Island, New York, combing through this storage unit as they build their case against the 59-year-old architect and married father, accused of killing three women more than a decade ago and suspected of killing a fourth.
This is clearly a sick and depraved human being, somebody who is taunting victims.
Crime scene detectives were seen at Huerman's home this weekend. Sources say investigators are hoping to find so-called trophies from the victim, such as earrings or locks of hair. They're also looking for evidence that could link him to six other local murders.
We're going to see if he's involved with the other deaths, and if not, then we'll continue to go after those that committed these crimes and hold them accountable.
Investigators say Huerman was hiding in plain sight. The case took a new turn last year when a task force of investigators took a fresh look at the evidence. They linked Huerman to a Chevy truck registered to him at the time of the murders, and similar to one reported by a witness when one of the victims disappeared in 2010. That witness described the suspect to police as appearing like an ogre. Earlier this year, a surveillance team recovered a pizza box with crust still inside, which they say Huerman had thrown out. They say DNA from the crusts matched a hair that was found on one of the victims. Meanwhile, associates of Huerman are now coming forward, one sharing a voicemail she got from him.
Hey, this is Rex.
Dominique Vidal was in a professional networking group with Huerman. She says the two once talked about true crime podcasts.
And he asked me if I had a favorite case. And then he asked me if I knew about the Gilgo Beach murders.
Rhiannon Alley, ABC News, New York.
Authorities say Huerman Googled the Gilgo Beach investigation more than 200 times. He's pleaded not guilty and is due back in court next month. The man accused of killing four people in a Henry County neighborhood in southwest Georgia is dead. Authorities say the suspect, Andre Longmore, died in a shootout with law enforcement on Sunday. A Henry County Sheriff's deputy and a Clayton County police officer were wounded in the exchange of gunfire. Longmore was accused of opening fire on Saturday. Police say they are relieved the manhunt for Longmore is over.
We tragically lost four citizens, and this community is grieving. None of us dreamed this day would come. We're thankful that we have achieved the resolution in which no more loss of life occurred.
The officers injured are expected to survive. Police on Sunday identified the four people killed in the mass shooting: Scott Levitt, his wife Shirley Levitt, and neighbors Steve Blizzard and Ronald Jeffers. All of the victims were in their 60s. While investigators have not determined a motive for the shooting, they say Longmore lived in the neighborhood and stole Blizzard's vehicle on Saturday.
We tragically lost.
Escaped inmate Michael Burham is back in custody in northwest Pennsylvania. He broke out of the Warren County prison more than a week ago. Police say a dog barking in an area not far from the prison alerted one of its owners on Saturday afternoon. A man then encountered Burham and left with his wife. They called police, and within 2 hours, Burham was back in custody. Authorities captured him in a wooded area. Police are now processing Burham and say he will not be returned to the Warren County prison. It's unclear where he will be held. Burham was jailed on burglary and kidnapping charges. He's also a suspect in a murder. Investigators are still trying to determine if he had any help in his escape.
I am very happy to be standing here in front of you to announce the capture of Michael Burham a short time ago here in Warren County. I want to thank the residents of Warren County and the surrounding area for their patience through all of this. I know it was challenging for them. I know they were nervous. I know they were scared. But, you know, they remained gracious to all of our people and were very, very helpful to all of us.
Jason Valentine returns now with a look at your morning weather forecast.
It's a First Alert weather day today, folks. We have a red flag warning, so heightened fire danger. We have cooler temperatures, but triple digits to return soon. All of your First Alert weather forecast coming right up.
Plus, a young entrepreneur in Rhode Island opens a lemonade stand to raise money for his local children's hospital.
Broadway's Rock of Ages, baby. July 21st at Legends Casino Hotel.
Smoke City for Less is your one-stop shop in Kennewick, Richland, Pasco, West Richland, and Hermiston. Every location is conveniently located. And now, Smoke City for Less Hermiston has relocated to North 1st Street by AutoZone. An easy turnoff at $3.95 and you are there. For the lowest prices and largest selection of vape mods, the best batteries, tobacco products, Kratom, and specialty products too. Open 7 days a week. Five locations, Kennewick, Richland, Pasco, West Richland, and the new location in Hermiston off $3.95. Smoke City for Less. We smoke the competition.
Like most backseat drivers, I'm all about safety. Pothole! Les Schwab Tires is too. Because Les Schwab fixes brakes, steering, and more. See those guys? They just do tires.
Eyes ahead, Dad!
Look, I'm not telling people how to do their job. Blinker! I'm just glad Les Schwab puts my safety first.
Watch, they're gonna come greet me.
Les Schwab Tires, doing the right thing since 1952.
Warning, your air conditioner unit needs service. Would you like me to call Bruce?
Yes, call Bruce.
Thanks to today's modern technology, it's never been easier to call Bruce Heating and Air. When your AC unit needs serviced, call Bruce.
Oh my gosh.
Let's get this party started.
Just make sure you call the right Bruce.
Now through September 30th, receive rebates up to $2,250 off on a new Daikin Fit system when you finance through Bruce Heating and Air. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Bruce Heating and Air.
I'm currently out of the office, focusing on a little blue sky thinking. I'll be taking meetings with family and friends and checking voicemail as my activities permit. I'll connect with you after reconnecting with me. Get 1.9% APR plus 500 purchase allowance on a 2023 Cadillac XT4, XT5, and XT6. Visit your Yakima and Tri-Cities Cadillac dealer today.
There are some people who have been tricked and lied to by someone they trust, someone they may even love, someone who sells them for sex. That's sex trafficking, and it's a crime. If you're a victim of sex trafficking, know that there is hope. There is a way out, a way to a better life. There are people who can help. You just need to take the first step.
The Support Advocacy and Resource Center, SARC, is here to help. Visit us at supportadvocacyresourcecenter.org. Services are free and confidential.
An awesome Idaho float adventure featuring good times, sun, and fun.
Great place out here. Just enjoy the river and soak up some sun.
Fly the Northwest.
In my opinion, one of the most beautiful parts of Idaho.
Apple Valley News Now at 6 Tuesday.
Next Live, Issa Rae from Barbie.
Let's do this!
Plus, from Claim to Fame,
Kevin and Frankie Jonas
are back.
Today at 9 on Apple Valley News Now.
A young boy in Rhode Island is making a difference with an inspiring initiative to help other kids. 9-year-old Theo Durson's lemonade stand raised $2,000 for Hasbro Children's Hospital.
What's in that lemonade? This is the third year in a row he has used the stand to benefit kids at the hospital. He says the first 2 years they raised $100. Durson himself receives treatment at Hasbro Children's Hospital for ADHD and Tourette's. Durson says he wants people to get better and to feel better like he does.
Oh, I love that. And you're never too little or too young to make a difference.
What did they do different?
Advertising.
Marketing. I like it. Just from $100 to $2,000, that's a pretty good increase.
They came back from the last year.
Man, he has a business degree.
Yes.
Ahead of him in the future. Quick look outside, everyone. A sunny start, a windy start to your day. We do have heightened fire danger. Thus, we have a first alert weather alert day. All of your forecast coming up next.
And with the passing of the latest debt ceiling bill, funding cuts for the CDC are starting to be felt at the state and local level. That's next on Good Morning Northwest.
America, it's the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of Ford trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need. Lock in great rates and get $1,000 trade assist cash on a 22 Escape or 23 Bronco Sport, only at your local Ford dealer.
Top Tree Service is committed to providing the best service and experience possible. From the first call to schedule your estimate, through our final after-service follow-up call, ensuring complete satisfaction. Your trees are valuable assets. and we ensure our ISA-certified arborists will protect your investment. The health and safety of your trees are our top priority. Call today to schedule a free estimate and experience the top tree service difference for yourself.
I've worked construction all my life. I take pride in my job and working hard. I've had my share of bumps and bruises.
Of all places, I get hurt shopping with my wife.
This injury affected every part of my life. The insurance company offered me nothing. I went to my buddy Scott Brumback and Sid Autumn. We ultimately filed suit. My lawyers fought hard for me and got a great result. These guys speak blue collar. Now I know what they mean by bulldog tough. Right, Mo?
Brumback and Autumn, bulldog tough.
There's more to life than the car you drive. It's the smell of fresh air and thrill of the outdoors. The celebration of life and the family that lives it with you. It's those little moments you wish would never end. Whether you need room for eight or enough torque for your weekend escape, no matter what your adventure, Corwin Ford will help you get there. Corwin Ford, family driven for over 100 years.
Electrifying rock stars from the original cast of the Broadway production now in concert. This is Broadway's Rock of Ages Band. Live and in concert. Friday, July 21st at Legends Casino Hotel. Tickets on sale now at Ticketmaster.com. Broadway's Rock of Ages Band, performing the monster hits that helped define the 80s.
For over 600 different premium cigars, including every cigar rated 95 and higher in the last decade, it's the Educated Cigar. For 115 different fine pipe tobaccos and 55 different briarwood pipes from England, Germany, and Italy, it's the Educated Cigar. For 95 and higher rated wines and White Bluff IPAs, it's the Educated Cigar in Richland.
America, come along with our adventure seekers, the Sanchez family, and discover summer with the Ford F-150. Lease a well-equipped 2023 F-150 for just $399 a month, only at your local Ford dealer.
Portions of Apple Valley News Now, sponsored by Lord's Health and Trios Health, making communities healthier. From Apple Valley News Now, First Alert Weather with Jason Valentine.
Good Monday morning, everyone. Well, hope you had a wonderful weekend. Nice morning so far. Plenty of sunshine, but we're seeing plenty of wind, especially as our day goes on. Thus, we have a red flag warning. We have low humidity, gusty winds, and dry conditions. And that's going to be until 11 o'clock tonight for all of our areas. So fire danger is red flag warnings, pretty much letting first responders know that we have heightened fire danger. Now, if we look at our wind advisory, that's good from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. today. Only for the Kittitas County areas. We could be seeing winds sustained 25 to 35 mile per hour, gusts up to 50 miles per hour. So heavy winds for Ellensburg or other cities will be looking at about 10 to 20 mile per hour winds. Could see gusts in the 20 to 30 mile per hour range. So again, blustery conditions throughout your day. That is heightening fire danger. Also warm this morning, lower 70s to mostly mid to upper 60s, 61 for Ellensburg. So we're having warm temperatures this morning, but we are going to get some relief from the heat. It is going to be pretty darn quick today and tomorrow. We're going to be right around that 90 degree mark to mid 80s. But by Thursday, we're going to be seeing return of the triple digits for many of our cities, and it's going to be quite warm on Wednesday as well. So we have quite a bit of hot temperatures on the way. So a little bit of a break to give us a break from all the heat we saw over the weekend. So in our future cast, we are going to continue to see very nice conditions, very sunny conditions, and that will continue pretty much for the week ahead. So not really any variance for our conditions, but still looking very, very nice. So as we move into our rest of our day, we're going to see these winds start to build up. We're in the mid-teens for most of our cities, a little slower in Yakima. And again, folks, batten down the hatches in Ellensburg. It is going to be quite windy. So overnight tonight, though, we'll see those winds slow down significantly. Tomorrow around 5 to 10 mile per hour winds. So a bit of a break from that. So tomorrow is going to be kind of the best day of the week if you're looking for those cooler temperatures and calm conditions. We are going to see winds slightly rise as we get into our weekend, but still nothing like we're seeing today. All right, mid-80s for Toppenish and Yakima, 76 for Ellensburg, about 10 or so degrees off of what we saw yesterday, mid to upper 80s for the Mid-Columbia. And in the Blue Mountain region, we're at those mid-80s as well. So we do have a weather alert day today, and it's going to return Thursday and Friday with those triple digits. Look at all that sunshine on the way. And folks, temperatures all over the place for the next 7 days. But the heat will be back on really Wednesday through Saturday. In the Tri-Cities area, 89 today, also an alert day for Thursday and Friday. Just want to keep everyone safe with these very, very hot temperatures. And again, the last couple of weeks, the hot temperatures were relegated to the weekend. Well, these are going to be showing up during our weekdays. And again, keep an eye out for all of that wind today, especially in the Kittitas Valley area. So fire danger raised today. Pretty nice day tomorrow, but then the heat will be back on starting on Wednesday. So batten down the hatches with that wind, especially in Kittitas, and keep an eye out for, well, fire danger throughout.
The CDC is facing big funding cuts, and some of the effects will be felt at the state and local level. The agency is poised to lose about $1.3 billion in funds as a result of last month's federal debt ceiling negotiation. The money was initially allocated through COVID-19 supplemental funding. The cuts will directly impact state and local health departments. The last 2 years of the five-year grant were slashed, worth more than $400 million. I'll be right back with the morning sprint and a final check on your forecast. But first, a look at what's ahead on Good Morning America.
In this morning's GMA First Look, passport application gridlock.
We lost train tickets, museum tickets that were not refundable. I had to cancel everything.
A dream vacation fell apart for Robin Fiala and her family. They were forced to cancel a trip to France because their children's passports never showed up. Robin says she applied on April 1st, but by the beginning of July, the passports still weren't in hand.
This is the one time of year that we all come together for however many days, and we do something fun as a family. And that's not happening.
Thousands of Americans have been stuck in limbo. The wait time for routine passport applications to process is now 10 to 13 weeks. Even expedited applications take 7 to 9 weeks. And coming up at 7 a.m., we'll have the expert tips you need to get that coveted passport in time for your trip. With your GMA First Look, I'm Trevor Ault, ABC News, New York.
Asthma isn't pretty. It's the moment when you realize that a good day is about to become a bad one. But then I remembered that the world is so much bigger than that, with Trelegy. Because one dose a day helps keep my asthma symptoms under control. And with three medicines and one inhaler, Trelegy helps improve lung function so I can breathe easier for a full 24 hours.
Trelegy won't replace a rescue inhaler for sudden breathing problems. Trelegy contains a medicine that increases risk of hospitalizations and death from asthma problems when used alone. When this medicine is used with an inhaled corticosteroid, like in Trelegy, there is not a significant increased risk of these events. Do not take Trelegy more than prescribed. Trelegy may increase risk of thrush and infections. Get emergency care for serious allergic reactions. See your doctor if your asthma does not improve or gets worse. What a wonderful
world. Ask your doctor about once daily Trelegy for asthma, because breathing should be beautiful.
Now, the morning sprint.
In a moment, but we begin with a look at this morning's top stories. A wildfire Friday afternoon in Kennewick shut down the eastbound lanes of 240, bringing it down to one lane. The fire was reported just after 2 p.m. Witnesses reported seeing the flames between the Columbia Center Boulevard and Steptoe exits. It's unknown what started the fire at this time, but crews remained at the scene over the next few hours to make sure hot spots didn't flare back up. Much of the flames were out by half an hour, and the lanes opened a short time later. And Pasco fire crews were also at work in the heat after a wildfire was reported on Road 52. Witnesses reported it was near Burns Road and it may have been started by fireworks. Crews got to the scene just after 2 o'clock and the flames were out within 20 minutes. With our hot, dry, and windy weather, fire officials are asking people to be mindful of using anything that can start a fire easily. We're learning more about a wildfire that broke out in Walla Walla County. Fire crews were called to the area of 15th Avenue and Reese Avenue just after 11:30 Thursday morning in Walla Walla County. Walla Walla City fire crews, as well as Walla Walla Fire Districts 4 and 8, were called to the scene. The fire was spotted along the end of West Reese Avenue and it was under control by noon. No injuries were reported, but the cause of the fire is still under investigation. 3 people are dead after a crash near Othello Saturday night, according to Washington State Patrol. A 30-year-old driver was traveling eastbound on State Route 26, approaching the intersection with Road D Southeast. His vehicle crashed head-on into a vehicle traveling westbound, killing all 3 occupants. The driver of the first vehicle has been transported to a local hospital and his condition is unknown at this time. A Union Gap man has been identified after a fatal car crash near Toppenish Saturday. According to a report from the Washington State Patrol, 34-year-old Felipe Uroio Stegui was driving northbound on SR 97 just before 4 a.m., about 2 miles north of Toppenish, when he rear-ended the vehicle in front of him. Authorities say the man then drove off the road and the vehicle rolled before coming to a rest on its wheels. He died at the scene. The other driver in the vehicle that was rear-ended was not hurt. Today, a major West Richland roadway is temporarily closing on Van Giesen from 62nd Avenue to Keene Road. Crews will be working on bringing water and sewer to the area, set to last until November. This project brings water and sewer, so existing residents have access to city water and fire hydrants. Engineers with the City of West Richland explain this needs to get done before the city can begin on an even bigger project on that roadway, the SR-224 and Red Mountain project.
Folks, it is a weather alert day today due to a red flag warning. We do have a beautiful morning. Starting to see winds pick up. Going to be a bit blustery as you head out the door. So red flag warning until 11 o'clock tonight. That means heightened fire danger due to heavy winds, low humidity, and dry conditions. We definitely have that. We also have a wind advisory in the Kittitas County area. Could see gusts up to 50 miles per hour. 25 to 35 mile per hour sustained. We'll see lighter winds 10 to 20 mile per hour. Still pretty gusty for Yakima and Tri-Cities today. So winds will continue to pick up as we move along in our day. So current temperatures, we are either in the lower 70s or mostly in the upper 60s, a little cooler for Ellensburg, but a very warm morning this morning. But we are looking at cooler temperatures today and tomorrow. We're going to be in the mid to upper 80s for most of our areas today, tomorrow, but then back to the upper 90s by Thursday, at least for the Tri-Cities, mid to upper 90s, and triple digits for some of our cities Thursday and Friday. So the heat will be back on. We do have a brief break from it today and tomorrow. So winds right now, we're at the mid-teens. Again, they're going to continue to build, especially Ellensburg, as we move along in our morning. Again, Ellensburg, your wind advisory is from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. That red flag warning, though, is until 11 o'clock tonight. Let's take a look at those highs. We're in the mid-80s for Yakima and Toppenish, 76 for Ellensburg in the mid-Columbia. Again, we're about 10 degrees off of what we saw yesterday, mid to upper 80s. And over in the Blues, we are in those mid-80s. So I just want to highlight, we have an alert day today and an alert day Thursday and Friday for Yakima with the return of those triple digits. So if you have been looking for relief, enjoy the next 2 days. And in the Tri-Cities, also alert days Thursday and Friday. And we'll keep a close eye on Saturday as well. So red flag warning until 11 o'clock tonight. Expect blustery conditions. Fire danger is raised. That wind advisory for Ellensburg, 8 to 8 o'clock today. We're going to calm down significantly by tomorrow. A pretty calm Tuesday is on the way with more or less light winds. But do get ready for the heat to return as we have a brief reprieve from the heat. It will be back Wednesday and in earnest Thursday and Friday. Jill.
Thanks for joining us on Good Morning Northwest. GMA is next. Your local news is back tonight at 5.